Hello, welcome once again. So we are back with a new video. We are coloring this bunny in this video. So for coloring, you have to make sure that your mRGB button is turned on and just select the material, select the color, then go to the color option and fill the color on the mesh. Fill color option means you have to click on fill color button. So by selecting the sub tool, the eyes and the nose, I have filled out the toy plastic material and with black color on these two subtools. Then for the other subtools, I will use skin shade material. Skin shade is a material in ZBrush which gives a wax type of preview, means it gives a skin type of look the model. For that bunny body, I am choosing a light pink type of color. I'm not that good in choosing colors also, so you can color this bunny in any color you want. There is no particular need to follow exactly what color I am using, what tools I am using, or what shapes I am using. You can change it anywhere you want, any how you want. For filling out the body color and the body material, I am selecting the subtool from the subtool menu, then filling the color by going to the color and fill color option. Then I am choosing the paintbrush, and the material is there, and the color I have already selected on the color palette. While smoothing the color, you have to make sure that your Z sub and Z adds are turned on. Only your RGB button should be turned on at that time. I'm using a black type of color for the mouth line of the bunny. Means you can just choose the color from the color palette, and you have to make sure that your mRGB or RGB button is turned on. Then you have to select the model, and if your model is in less resolution or if the model have less density, then the color will look little jagged. But if the density is fine, means you have a very dense model, like a model after sculpting it in Dynamesh, you can color it out in that same Dynamesh version. Like in this example, I have selected the body, then I am choosing the color, then with the paintbrush, I will paint the part in different color. I will choose something light. Earlier, I have told you that line which I have made for this shape, I will use a color for making this shape. So I'm using a white color for making that shape. I am not using sculpted separation for that stomach area. So I'm smoothing the edges of the color by holding shift key, and shift key will help you to smooth out the colors also. And I'm filling out the gaps in the ear carefully and smoothing out the colors at the same time, and making sure that while smoothing out the colors, I'm not smoothing out the mesh. So make sure that your RGB button or mRGB button is turned on, not your Z sub and Z add. Little bit of blush on the cheeks. So basically, coloring a model is very simple in ZBrush. You just have to select the color, select the material, select the brush, and select the mesh, then just paint on the model. I think bunny is looking good, but there is one problem. The problem is here. The paintbrush which I am using is painting on the backside also. So for that, for turning off that option, you have to go to the auto masking option, then back face mask. Then after turning on that option, you can pick the color from the model and you can paint over it again. Then you will see the backside of the ear is not turning again with different color. So that is how you can solve this problem. Make sure to turn on the back face of your brush, back face masking of your brush. I'm changing the tail color, making it a little dark pink. At this time, I'm just coloring the model however I want. So here is our bunny model completed with the colors. And you can render it out for the final image. And for rendering, I have already told you in my other videos, you can go and just have a look at them, and you will find out that rendering is also very easy. And if you don't get that point of rendering a character or rendering your character in ZBrush at the same time when you sculpt and color it in the ZBrush, then let me know in the comment section. I will make a more detailed video of the rendering process in ZBrush. So keep sculpting and like, share, and subscribe my videos. Thank you so much.